I'm Joe Calloway. I'm in town to do some work with TD Canada Trust, which I'm very excited about. I'm here to help stir up some ideas. I've been doing this for 28 years, and by this I mean everything from doing seminar-type training, a lot of video training, like what you see going on behind us. I've done a lot of speaking at employee events.
That would be like a financial services company saying, choose us because we have great people, great service, we care about you, you get me, we care about our community, and all that stuff that everybody says.
I've kind of got one job, and that job is to constantly look at business, look at what works with customers, and then say, all right, what is it that market leaders have in common?
It's a fun job because I get to work with all kinds of companies, and a lot of them are companies that you'd recognize, like IBM and BMW, or you know, Saks Fifth Avenue in retail. You learn that as different as all these companies are,
everybody's facing the same kinds of challenges. And so the question is, what are we willing or able to do that the competition's not willing or able to do? You know, there may be an example from something that a hospital is doing that you talk about it to branch managers, and the branch managers say, well, wait, we could do that. So I bring an outside perspective. My job is to pass that on in such a way that it gets people thinking about what they do in a new way.
Yeah, the five key points that we're going to zero in, and we put them together this way. The first is a new way of thinking, and by that we mean you own it. It's everybody's job. Everybody owns the responsibility to create an experience for the customer that is a compelling experience, that will differentiate the bank, that will win that customer and keep that customer. Your brand is the same thing as your job. Your brand slash your job is the experience that your customers have when they do business with you. It's actually the customer's perception of what it's like to do business with you. That is your only job. And I would say that to any employee in any company anywhere. I don't care if they're 20 people removed from customer contact. Their job exists to enable the organization to create an experience that is so compelling that it commands customer loyalty. The second idea I think would have to be to get rid of complacency. Listen, your biggest threat is not external, it's internal, because you're good at what you do. You know, you've got the awards on the wall to prove that. You're a leader in customer satisfaction and customer service. But that's a double-edged sword. It's really easy to say, hey, we're number one, therefore, let's just keep doing what we're doing. But see, the world doesn't do that. The customers get more demanding. The competition gets better. If you are successful, good for you. You know what used to work. You know what I can do? I can compete and win in markets that no longer exist. I think the third idea is, and it's a title of one of my books, Becoming a Category of One, to differentiate yourself in a business where customers, you know, customers see banks as commodities.
If you can separate yourself from the competition, then you become a category of one.
How do we leave all the other banks over here in the banking category, in the financial services category, and we separate ourselves out to where we, in the eyes of the marketplace, in the eyes of customers, and even potential customers, there is a clear difference. Don't try and be a leader in the category of financial services. Create a separate category and be the only one in it. In the minds of the customers, you become so differentiated that they're thinking, well, yeah, I could get a loan here, and I could have a checking account here, and I could have lockbox services here, and I could have merchant credit card services here. It's more than buying services. They help me take care of fill in the blank, my family, my finances, my future, my business. Another one that's absolutely critical because it's at the core of what makes a brand strong is consistency of performance. Consistency of performance is the brand builder. Inconsistency of performance is the brand killer.
Here's the thing. While people are different, personalities are different, you know, in a branch like this, you've got all kinds of customers, you've got all kinds of people working here, but The customers have to be able to depend on a consistently great customer experience, no matter who they deal with in this branch, no matter which branch they go to, or if it's on the phone, or if it's on the internet.
I made a call not too long ago. I don't know what it was, but it was some 1-800 customer service line. I think it was an insurance deal. I wanted to know if our insurance policy would enable us to do a certain thing. I called the 1-800 number and I say, here's what I'd like to do. Can we do that under our policy? Oh no, sir, there's no way we can do that. I said, thank you very much. You ever done this? I hung up, picked the phone right back up, dialed the 1-800 number again, just hoping I'd get somebody different. How many people in the room have done that? Woman picks up the phone. I said, hey, this is the policy we've got. Can we do that? She says, well, sure. That's easy. What's up with that?
And then finally, it's this idea that, you know, we're not just going to have a meeting and talk about this stuff, have a pep rally, and then go back to work and do it the way we've always done it. We're going to decide to go. We're going to decide to take action. And that means, look, we know what we have to do. But now I've made the decision that I'm going, and I'm taking everybody else in this branch with me. We're going to go together, and we're going to make a difference.
Now, here's the fascinating thing. Most companies never have that conversation. I mean, they come to meetings and conventions, and they have cheerleading sessions, and the assumption is that everybody wants to take it to the next level. But they never have the conversation. They talk about going, but they don't decide to go. Do you see the difference?
You know, it's leadership's responsibility to own it first, because the people in the branches, the people in the call centers, the people in the back office, they're not going to own it. They're not going to own the responsibility for the customer, for the success of the organization, until they see and until they feel in their hearts that leadership owns it. And to get that ownership happening requires communication and more communication and more communication, to the point where it honestly is just relentless. You talk about the values, you talk about the targets, the goals, and you talk about it all the time, because then it becomes culture.
For over 27 years, Joe Calloway has helped great companies get even better. Please welcome best-selling author, performance consultant, and business expert, Joe Calloway.
If I were to say to successful CEOs or business owners, what's the one best idea you could give them? Not that it would be unanimous, but I think I know what would get the most number of votes. It would be this, because I've heard it over and over and over. They would say, tell them to go. Tell them to make the decision. Tell them to light the fuse. Tell them to take action. Get on with it. This is not going to be real speechy. You're probably going to do more talking than me. This is going to be a big conversation. You're going to have a lot going on. And so it's not going to be speech. How do you become an innovative company? And I tell you what, it's not about process. You know, in your business, there's a lot of process that goes on. And it has to. It's kind of the nature of business. This is much, much more about mindset than it is process. But believe me, mindset is just as real and just as impactful as any process will ever be. He taps me on the shoulder. I turn around and he goes, hey, buddy, can you see me? And the little girl says, I'm drawing a picture of God. The teacher laughs. She says, but honey, nobody knows what God looks like. Little girl says, they will in a couple of minutes. And Marty, I want me some of that. Man. What if you were to look at the basics of how you do your business and pick three of them and say, we're going to get 20% better at this, this, and this? Just the basics. Because a lot of times, that's where you start to differentiate. Have you ever ended a meeting by everybody saying, okay, we all together? We all in on this? Yes. And as you walk out the room, you're thinking, she's no more in on this than the man in the mirror. Why are we walking out under this guise of everybody being in on it? We're not. Great companies stay in the room and say, if you're not in on it, tell me. Let's get it on the table. Maybe you've got a good reason. Let's hear that. Get out of the box, get out of your particular business, get out of government, and look and see what's going on down the street. See, your next best idea could be anywhere. It could be in this mall right out here. See, I'd love it if we could take a field trip and walk through the mall for 3 hours and then come back with a list of things that you saw out there that your organization should be doing and a list of things you saw out there that you better be sure your organization isn't doing. And I don't know if you caught the title of that one, but Becoming a Category of One. And the idea is what I just illustrated, that all your competitors are over here and they are in a category. Good for them. And there may be a leader in that category. Good for them. But you want to create a category and you're the only one in it. I'll tell you what, when they go off the top of that list, I'll change the subject. Because being successful is one thing. Sustaining success, that's a whole different deal. I got to meet Herb Kelleher, who started Southwest a few years ago in Kansas City. I went up to him. I said, Mr. Kelleher, I know this. I know the answer to this. I'd just love to hear you say it. What makes Southwest different from all the other airlines? He said, well, son, it's a couple of things. It's price, it's efficiency. If you've ever heard Kelleher, seen him on TV, he smokes a cigarette all the time. Never catch him without a cigarette. He sounds kind of like this. He said, two big things are love and fun. We love everybody. I mean everybody. We love customers. We love their money. We love each other. Our people love each other. They couldn't work together that way if they didn't love each other. They all love me. You ask them, they'll tell you they love me. You know why? I love them. I tell them all the time I love them. How can you run a business and not talk about love? I don't understand it. He said, the other thing is fun. He said, we have more fun than the law ought to allow. Let me tell you something, son. If you're really good at what you do, you love everybody, you're having fun, hell, you make so much money you can't count it all.
Joe Calloway is an expert at helping companies tell their story, creating communication that engages employees and inspires them to do great things. From Saks Fifth Avenue and BMW to American Express and IBM, a wide range of companies depend on Joe for ideas to help them create and sustain success. Joe is the author of the best-selling book, Becoming a Category of One, which received rave reviews from the New York Times, Retailing Today, and many others. Joe's other books include Indispensable, How to Become the Company Your Customers Can't Live Without, and Work Like You're Showing Off. Joe also helps companies connect with their customers at customer forums and events, and he is known for making the program really connect with the audience through onstage conversations.
Help me welcome Steve Lilly, First Community Bank Chair.
The intellectual part of it was also very stimulating as well.
There was, by the way, I got to say, I love talking to this guy. You don't have any kind of weird accent I have to get through. I can talk to him.
They looked at their branches in a whole new light. People went in, cleaned off their desks. They made sure that the dead plants were removed. They understood the fact that we now...
Rocket science.
That's right, stuff. Rocket scientists.
Wow.
You know, but what the clue scanning provided
Look,
them...
People are actually taking notes.
Yeah,
Dad.
Yeah.
Joe often helps companies make an impact on their event by bringing top performers, company leaders, or the CEO on stage in short interviews to make them part of his presentation.
Yeah. Use the word emotion.
Yeah.
Think this is an emotional business?
Oh, hell yeah.
Of course it is.
Yeah.
Thanks,
Joe. Thanks.
Whether it's through videos that Joe uses in his presentation, customized videos produced specifically for the client, articles, or e-communication, Joe helps businesses and their employees go to new levels of performance.
Let's say that the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of us all work together and we've gone off to come up with some new ideas. And what is your name? Right here, right in front of me. Debbie? Debbie, we're talking about new ideas and throwing stuff out. And Debbie throws an idea out on the table. She says, well, you know, I think maybe we should do this. And we all look at each other and look at Debbie and we go, whoa, Debbie, that's a good idea. We should do that. I mean, we were all saying it. That's a good idea, Debbie. Okay, what are the chances that it probably is a really good idea? You're pretty darn good. What are the chances that it is a truly innovative idea. Maybe, but probably pretty slim, because if she throws a truly innovative idea on the table, what's the reaction much more likely to be? Debbie, you've just gone to that place you go to sometimes. That other reality. You know, yeah, that would be great, Debbie. Let me point one thing out. I don't know of a single bank on this planet or any other that's ever done that. Maybe there's a reason, Debbie. And it won't work. I don't know whose budget it's going to come out of. It's not coming out of mine, I'll tell you that. Listen, innovation means you go first. That's tough for people to do sometimes.
Joe Calloway believes it's about much more than just giving a speech. That's not the point. The speech is never the point. The point is your vision for your organization, where you're trying to go. And Joe's mission is to help them engage people in meaningful ways to challenge and inspire them to do great things.
Michelangelo said, the problem with most of us, the great danger for most of us, lies not in setting our aim too high and missing it. The great danger is that we set our aim too low and what? Hit it. Thank you very much for having me. Have a great, great time tonight. Thank you very, very much.